As kids, everybody loves to play with a remote-controlled car. Since I am an adult now, I decided to modify the car. The car I am using is a generic RC car which uses a 27 MHz transmitter for the remote and a 27 MHz receiver which will be inside the car. I wanted to accomplish this with as little changes as possible to the original car's electronics. Hence, to keep it simple and easy, I decided to just hack the remote of the RC car. My idea is to develop some interface between the remote and my laptop. So I'll keep the car aside for now. I opened the remote by removing all the screws from the back. By having a look inside, I noticed it has four metal strips which touch down onto four contacts. Unlike what I thought, these metal strips are only used for making contact and don't act like spring to push the contact back, as there is a separate spring inside the lever for that. Upon pushing the strip onto the PCB, the transmitter will send out an encoded signal to the receiver, which is done by this IC, which is TX2B, which comes with its pair RX2B, which will be inside the car. Upon downloading and studying the datasheet, I noticed there are 5 separate pins, which when connected to ground, will send the encoded signal to the receiver, which the receiver decodes to know which among the 5 keys was pressed, that is, forward, backward, left, right, or turbo. Putting my multimeter into continuity mode and checking the connections, I found that these metal strips are connected to ground, and pins on the board below the metal strip connect to the respective forward, backward, left and right pins of the IC. I also noticed the turbo pin was not used. Since by pressing the lever, we are just manually grounding these pins, we can also do that electronically by using a microcontroller. I decided to use a basic 8051 microcontroller, that is Nuaton's W78E052, along with a small breakout board. I soldered 4 wires onto the 4 contact pins below the strip and hooked them to the 4 pins of the 8051 breakout board. I also soldered 2 wires to the battery terminals of the remote and soldered them to the power supply pins of the board so that both 8051 and the remote can run on same voltage, that is 5 volt, which according to the datasheet is the maximum voltage that this IC can handle. And also with these connections, both circuits can have a common ground, which is essential for this to work properly. I'm going to send laptop keys information to the microcontroller via a serial terminal program and use this USB to TTL converter. Microcontroller will decode which key is pressed and ground the respective pins. I'm using a USB to TTL converter which at one end connects to the USB port of the laptop and the other end to the TX and RX pins of the microcontroller. I connected 5V and ground pins of the converter to the 8051 board so I can power both microcontroller and the RC remote from the USB port. Finally, I wrote a simple code to initialize the 8051 in serial mode at 9600 baud rate. And a switch case code to ground the respective pins of the IC based on which key I pressed on the keyboard. After programming, I compiled the code and programmed the chip using Nuaton's ISP utility. Since Nuaton's W78E052 chip has inbuilt bootloader, much like P89V51RD2, I can program the chip using the USB to TTL converter, which I already connected to the board. After that, I opened the serial terminal, initialized it to 9600 baud rate, and started pressing the keys. And as expected, car responded pretty well to the setup. I used the keys W, A, S, and D for forward, left, backward, and right, respectively. Since these keys are usually used to play simple car and bike games on computer. There was one problem though. When I press forward or backward key, the car's wheels would go forward and backward. But when I press left or right, the front wheels of the car would just turn to left or right and not move the car. In order to fix this, I modified left and right commands to ground the forward pin together with the left and right pin, so that the car would move in that direction. And I also added some commands to move the car backward left and backward right. After these modifications to the program, I compiled it once more and reprogrammed the IC. Finally, I could now maneuver the car in pretty much any direction. This was a fun project to do. If you like this project, give a thumbs up to the video and subscribe to the channel to watch more upcoming projects. Thank you. See you again.